Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I am Hamad Yusuf. The Deputy King, His Royal Highness Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, held his weekly majlis at Rafah Palace. The Deputy King emphasized that the Bahraini identity, which is based on shared values of diversity and coexistence, serves as the bedrock of all development milestones achieved under the leadership of His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa. He added that the Kingdom's national values have strengthened the cohesion among diverse communities, enabling Bahrain to turn challenges into new opportunities for growth. The visitors extended their appreciation to the Deputy King for hosting the Majlis, which stands as a demonstration of Bahrain's commitment to deep-rooted traditions and values. Members of the royal family, senior government officials, members of the Shura, representatives and municipal councils, religious and community leaders, journalists and diplomats attended the Majlis. Thank you. The Deputy King, His Royal Highness Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received the Minister of Housing, Basim Al Hamad, at Dibiya Palace to review the development of housing projects across the Kingdom's governorates. The Deputy King highlighted that Bahrain continues to direct all its efforts to develop programs and initiatives that benefit its citizens in line with the Kingdom's comprehensive development plan and in accordance with the vision of His Majesty the King. He noted that in line with the directives of His Majesty the King, he instructed the recent allocation of 5,000 housing units to citizens, which reflects their continuous emphasis on implementing and delivering on government plans for housing. His Royal Highness the Deputy King concluded by further stressing the importance of enhancing all processes related to the housing sector in order to guarantee its sustainable growth, enhance the participation of the private sector, and support the advancement of the Kingdom and its citizens. Deputy Prime Minister and Chairman of the Ministerial Committee for Development Projects and Infrastructure, Sheikh Khaled bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, the Minister of Finance and National Economy, Sheikh Salman bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, and the Minister of Works, Municipalities Affairs and Urban Planning, Asam Khalaf, also attended the meeting. The Deputy King, His Royal Highness Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, received the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khaled bin Ahmed bin Muhammad Al Khalifa, at Dibiya Palace, in the presence of the Minister of Finance and National Economy, Sheikh Salman bin Khalifa Al Khalifa. His Royal Highness, the Deputy King, highlighted the dedication and commitment of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs to advancing the Kingdom's diplomatic agenda regionally and internationally in line with the Kingdom's comprehensive development led by His Majesty the King. The Deputy King extended his gratitude for the tireless efforts made by the Minister to further strengthen Bahrain's relations with regional and international partners and preserve the Kingdom's diplomatic interests. He concluded by wishing Sheikh Khaled further success in his next role. The Minister of Foreign Affairs expressed honor for the opportunity to serve His Majesty the King, the Kingdom and its citizens. He highlighted the Ministry's substantial role in consolidating the Kingdom's firm stance on various international issues, as well as its support of international efforts aimed at strengthening regional security and stability. Sheikh Khaled expressed gratitude and appreciation for the unwavering support provided by His Royal Highness in further advancing Bahraini diplomacy. He concluded by wishing the current Secretary General of the GCC, Dr. Abdel Latif Zayani, success as Minister of Foreign Affairs. The BDF Commander-in-Chief, Field Marshal Sheikh Khalifa bin Ahmed Al Khalifa, received the Saudi Ambassador to the Kingdom, His Royal Highness Prince Sultan bin Ahmed bin Abdulaziz Al Saud, on the occasion of his new appointment in the presence of the Minister of Defense Affairs, Lieutenant General Abdullah bin Hassan Naimi, and Chief of Staff, Lieutenant General Diab bin Sagr Al Naimi. The BDF Commander-in-Chief wished the Ambassador success in performing his diplomatic duties and praised the historic bilateral relations and the keenness of both leaders to further bolster these relations on all levels. The meeting was attended by Undersecretary of the Ministry of Defense, Sheikh Ahmed bin Muhammad Al Khalifa, Director of the General Command Court, Major General Hassan Muhammad Saad, Assistant Chief of Staff for Supply, Assistant Chief of Staff for Human Resources, Major General Sheikh Ali bin Rashid Al Khalifa, Director of Military Cooperation, Rear Admiral Muhammad Hashim Assada, Assistant Chief of Staff for Operations, Major General Ghanim Ibrahim Al Fadala, and a number of senior BDF officers. The Interior Minister, General Sheikh Rashid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, visited the General Directorate of Civil Defense, where he was received by the Public Security Chief, Major General Tariq Al Hassan, and the Director General of Civil Defense, where he met with a number of civil defense officers and praised their sincere efforts and outstanding professional performance in protecting lives and property. He stressed that the draft law on volunteering to serve public security, which comes out of loyalty and belonging to the country, and the promotion of joint social responsibility to protect security and stability is one of the pillars of security work, noting that it is based on the principle of community partnership when it comes to preserving the country's security. He also expressed aspiration to complete the necessary legal procedures to approve the proposed project. Director General of Civil Defense affirmed keenness to perform their duty in a professional manner, which is required during emergencies and disasters in accordance with the approved international standards. The minister then was briefed about the general plan to develop civil defense and its implications for increasing the number of civil defense centers according to the requirements, as well as developing operational capabilities and a work plan. He stressed the importance of investing in training cadres alongside modern equipment and continuing to develop rapid response in all circumstances and locations. He noted that the bonuses for civil defense personnel will be adjusted in recognition of the dangerous tasks they perform. The Interior Minister praised the cooperation of citizens and residents with the security men in the performance of their duties in order to maintain security and promote stability, calling for the necessity for their response to the instruction provided by the civil defense through radio, television, newspaper, social media, and SMS messages. The minister then directed the General Directorate of Civil Defense to intensify awareness campaigns to increase public awareness. In the presence of the Minister of Justice, Islamic Affairs and Endowment, Sheikh Khaled bin Ali Al Khalifa, and the Deputy Chairman of the Supreme Council for Justice and President of the Court of Cassation, Advisor Abdullah bin Hassan Al Bu'aynain, a workshop on the role of civil community institutions in contributing to applying the penal code and alternative measures was held under the patronage of the Attorney General, Dr. Ali bin Fadl Al Bu'aynain, with the wide participation of civil community representatives and institutions. The Attorney General affirmed the importance of the workshop, which comes in continuation of the efforts exerted of the effective application of alternative penal code. He stated that applying the law's provisions requires the continuous development of comprehensive plans on applying them. He noted the keenness on expanding the scope of the penal code and alternative measures application in light of the royal directives in this regard. Under the patronage of the Minister of Health, Faiq Al-Saleh, the fifth conference for AIDS was held. The minister affirmed the ministry's keenness and care towards such conferences to raise the status of the kingdom on the regional and international levels. She stressed the importance of the event in raising awareness regarding the virus and showcased international collective efforts in combating it. She pointed out that the Kingdom of Bahrain has adhered to the United Nations Agreement to Combat AIDS through a decision issued by the cabinet to form a national committee for HIV prevention, and the Ministry of Health was tasked with chairing this committee and set up strategic plans to help those who are living with and affected by HIV, which reflects a community partnership between government and non-government institutions to achieve the goals of dealing with this issue. On behalf of Survey and Land Registration Bureau President and Real Estate Regulatory Authority Chairman, Sheikh Salman bin Abdullah bin Hamad Al-Khalifa, RERA Chief Executive Officer Sheikh Mohammed bin Khalifa Al-Khalifa opened the 8-in-1 Expo at Bahrain International Exhibition and Convention Center. More on this report with Habab Al-Ghaffar.
The Real Estate Regulatory Authority opens today the 8-in-1 Expo, organized by First Target Consulting and Exhibitions, aiming to strengthen the exhibitions and conferences sector, which plays a vital role in revitalizing the national economy.
I'm really happy to see the number of presenters and the exhibitors in this exhibition. It was really exciting that we host this event as the second year in a row. The numbers are increasing year by year, and I hope this is going to continue for the years to come.
Of course, this kind of exhibition is very important for Bahrain, especially for the market, and to accept the investment, which we are doing as much as we can to support the investment in Bahrain.
With the participation of more than 180 local and international exhibitors, the 8-in-1 Expo includes several exhibitions such as Bahrain International Modern House, Bahrain International Technology Expo, the International Health and Beauty Expo, including various products and services in the fields of real estate, interior design, furniture, the latest advancements in the health field, and much more.
We are here for widen our scope, and we introduce our services to new clients, to meet our patients face to face, let them know our technologies, our doctors.
I think it's a very nice opportunity for us to know what people want, what people are interested more in Bahrain, and for us to seek more opportunities in the market.
It's a good opportunity to meet potential clients, individuals and companies, and to meet other colleagues as well in construction sector.
A good opportunity to expose our work to different companies and attract many health workers into to know which facilities we are using and what other services we are providing.
What characterizes the 8-in-1 Expo is that it includes a large variety of products and services under one roof, meeting the demands of visitors with different tastes and needs.
8-in-1 Expo opens today, providing an opportunity for more than 180 exhibitors to showcase the latest in the field of real estate, construction, interior design, health, and much more. Moreover, exchange experiences with counterparts in the same field and widen their exposure. Hiba Abdelghaffar, Bahrain International.